हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ई क्लासेस ऑफ पी एन एमर्से हाई स्कूल। होप यू ऑल आर सेफ एट योर होम। टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट आर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 3, हाउ मेनी स्क्वायर्स। द चैप्टर इज अबाउट एरिया एंड पेरीमीटर। बिफोर वी स्टार्ट द चैप्टर, लेट अस नो अबाउट द बेसिक कंसेप्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर। Before we discuss about perimeter and area, let us explain you something about square and rectangle. Now, what is a square? A square is a shape with four equal sides. You can see here a figure is given which has four sides, 1, 2, 3, 4, and all its four sides are of equal measurement. Here you can see that this side is of 3 centimeters. This is also of 3 cm and this is also 3 cm and this is also of 3 cm. So, a square shape has 4 equal sides. Next, rectangle. A rectangle is a shape with opposite side equal. Here you can see this is a shape given. Here the opposite sides are equal. Here also it's 5 cm. And here also the side is of 5 cm. This side is of 2 cm and this is also of 2 cm. So we can say that a shape with opposite sides of equal measurement is called as rectangle. Perimeter. The sum of the measure of all the sides of any closed figure is called the perimeter of that figure. Perimeter means the sum of the measure. Sum means to add. We have to add the measure of all the sides of any closed figure. Then we get the perimeter of that figure. Suppose for example, here a figure is given. You can see here the side of this figure has 2 cm measurement. This side has 2 cm measurement. This has 3 cm. This has 2 cm and this side has 2 cm. Now to find out the perimeter, we have to add all the sides. So perimeter is equals to AB plus BC plus CD plus DE plus EA. We have to add all the sides. By adding all the sides, we get the answer 11 cm. So we can say that to find out the perimeter, you have to just add the measurement given on all the sides of that figure. The units of perimeter are centimeter, meter, kilometer, etc. The perimeter of a square. To find out the perimeter of a square, we have to follow the formula length plus length plus length plus length. As you know, the length of a square is same on all its four sides. So all the four sides of length we have to plus, or we can multiply the length by 4. You can use either this method or this method to find out the perimeter of square. Perimeter of rectangle. Length plus breadth plus length plus breadth. As I've explained you that the rectangle has two of its opposite sides equal. So instead of writing length plus breadth plus length plus breadth, we can write 2 multiplied by length plus breadth. So we have to find out the perimeter of rectangle. Any of the method can be, formula can be used. Now our next topic is area. The measure of the amount of the surface covered by a closed figure is known as the area of the figure. We have to find out the measure of the amount of the surface covered by a closed figure. Here also we have to take a closed figure and then we have to find its measure of amount of the surface covered. Whatever the surface is covered in the closed figure, we have to find out its measure, which is known as the area of the figure. Here few rules we have to follow. First, the figure is placed or drawn on a graph paper. The figure covers some whole, some half, some less than half, and some more than half squares. Here, the figure which is drawn on a graph paper will consist of some whole squares, some half squares, some less than half squares, and some more than half squares. We have to measure accordingly. Count the complete square as whole, which are enclosed in the figure. If in the figure complete squares are given, then we will complete it as whole. Count the squares as whole which are covered more than half by the figures. If in the figure, if the square is covered more than half of the surface, then also we will count it as a whole. Next, count the square as half which are covered half by the figure. Two half squares make one whole square. If the square is covered half, then we will consider it as a half. And by taking two half squares, we will get one whole square. Ignore the squares which are covered less than half by the figure. If in the figure, the squares which are covered less than half, we will ignore that square. Hence, the sum of all the squares covered by the figure is called the area of that figure. Then if we add that all the squares covered by that figure, then we will get area of that figure. I will explain you this with an example. See students, this is a graph paper. Here shapes can be made up of whole square, half square, more than half square, less than half square. Here you can see that here a square is made. If the figure contains the whole square, then we will count it as 1. If the square in the figure is half, see this is a square and half we have taken here also, this is a square and half we have taken, then 2 half square means 1 whole square. See here, a square is given and we have taken more than half of the part. The more than half of the square is considered as a whole square. And this is less than half square. We have to ignore less than half square in the figure. Now students will explain you this concept with some figures. Here you can see a figure is given. In this figure, whole squares are given. We have to just count how many full squares are given. So you can see that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Complete 12 squares are there in this figure. So figure 1 has 12 whole squares. Therefore the area of this figure is 12 square centimeter. Now here you can see another figure is given. In this figure also we have to count how many complete squares are given and how many more than half squares are given, how many less than half squares are given and how many half squares are given. Here you can see the simple way to find out and to count how many complete squares are there. First, what we have to do, we have to put a write on the complete square. See 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So in this figure, 5 complete squares are there. And we will put a cross on half square. Here 2 half squares are given. So figure 2 has 5 whole squares and 2 half squares. As I have explained you earlier that the whole square you have to count as 1 and 2 half squares will be considered as 1 whole square. So 5 plus 1, therefore the area is equals to 6 square centimeter. Now figure number 3, here also a figure is given. Here also we will count how many complete squares are there, how many less than half squares are there and how many more than half squares are there. And how many half squares are there? So here also what we will do, we will put a right on the complete squares and see, you can see that this is more than half square. So we have put cross on more than half square. These two are half squares. So another symbol triangle we are putting here. And this is less than half square. So figure number 3 has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14. 14 whole squares. And 1 and 2, 2 half squares. 1 and 2, 2 more than half squares. And 1 less than half squares. As I've explained you that whole square you have to count as 1. 2 half squares means 1 whole square. And more than half square you have to count as whole square only. And we have to ignore less than half square. We will not count this less than half square. So we will add now 14 whole squares. 2 half squares means 1 whole square. 2 more than half square means 2 whole square. By adding 14 plus 2 plus 1 we get 17. So the area of this figure is 17 square centimeter. And another way to find out the area is, if you have to find the area of a square, the formula to find out the area of square is length multiplied by length. And the area of a rectangle, to find out the area of rectangle, we will multiply length by breadth. And the units of area are square centimeter, square meter and square kilometer. With this we end our today's video and will continue with our chapter in the next video. Thank you.